In this demo, we will focus on the printing features in ARES Commander to help you understand how they compare with AutoCAD or other similar programs. To begin with, you will hear about the configuration of sheets with viewports and title blocks. Secondly, we will talk about sheet sets. Next, we will talk about the print dialog and the printing configuration files. And finally, you will hear about PDF export and import. The first thing I would like to show is the sheet tabs that you can find next to the Model Space tab. These are the same as in AutoCAD. Only in AutoCAD they're called layouts, while in ARES we name them sheets. If I do a right click on any of these tabs, I could also create a new sheet or access the Page Layout Manager to define the paper size. Let's create a second viewport in this sheet, but this time using a closed entity. With a double click inside the viewport, I can roughly adjust the content with the mouse wheel. But to define a specific scale, it is easier to click on Annotation in the status bar. This also gives me the opportunity to show the support of annotation scaling. Inside the circle, you see this dimension and text. While inside the rectangle, they are not visible. See also how annotative scaling is helping us to show the same hatch in different scales. Now, let's move to our second topic, the sheet sets. With a right click in the ribbon, we will call the Sheet Set Manager palette. The first thing to highlight is that we can import a DST file. As it is the same format, you can work in ARES with sheet sets created with AutoCAD and vice versa. The benefit of sheet sets is to combine drawings from different DWG files and to reorganize the pages in a logical order. The Sheet Set Manager also makes it easier to add and configure new sheets. Let's add a viewport to this sheet. We see that ARES Commander supports fields. This enables us to update all the sheets to change the revision number. One more reason to use sheet sets is the publish feature. Again, it is very similar to AutoCAD and can be used to print on paper or to PDF. As you can see, the publish command is now running in the background. The publish feature is using the print settings you saved in the sheets, so it makes it easy to print your entire project in one click. With the publish feature, we obtained a PDF with multiple sheets in the defined paper sizes and scales. Now, let's take a closer look at the print dialog. Obviously, you will find here all the options to configure the paper size and scale. After selecting the printer, you will see the preview. In the list of printers, you will also find the PDF export. If you select PDF, you will see the PDF options. In this dialog, you could, for example, decide to enable the layers in the PDF that will be generated. In turn, the Import button will let you import a PC3 file, which is also used in AutoCAD to configure printers, only it will be converted into a file whose extension is PCX in ARES Commander. Finally, on the right-hand side, you will find the option to create or import print stylelet tables. Both ARES Commander and AutoCAD use the CTB and STB file formats. By default, some CTB files are already provided, such as grayscale.ctb. If you click on Edit, you can modify each CTB or STB file. To import a CTB or STB print style table, you need to copy it to the corresponding folder, whose path you can find in the System Options. Finally, let's talk about PDF import. PDF files, like this one, are very easy to share. But when we receive drawings in this format, we cannot make modifications. This is why we need the PDF import feature. Let's try to convert this file back to DWG. To begin with, we see that we can not only import one file, but also batch process multiple files. Secondly, after selecting a PDF file with multiple pages, we can choose which ones we want to import. Note that these two features do not exist in AutoCAD. After selecting one or more sheets to import, you could also check the options. This is particularly important for the layers. Three options are available. You can import all the geometry in the current layer, or create layers by entity color. But in our case, we have layers in the PDF, so we will use this option. The next step will be to insert the imported geometry as a block inside your drawing. After insertion, we can check if it was imported at the right scale and use the scale command to adjust accordingly. Finally, we can explode the inserted block to modify the geometry. To conclude, the printing features of ARES Commander are very similar to those of AutoCAD, but you get a small bonus with ARES Commander's PDF import features.